The concept of the moonshot is to identify problems that are of such fundamental importance that if they can be solved, they will materially benefit the human race.
Solving complex problems with a quantum computer is rapidly moving from science fiction to science reality. Before long, quantum computers will help us advance national security, develop new vaccines and life-saving drugs, discover new materials, make complicated calculations at blinding speed, and the world gains a deeper understanding of nature and humanity itself.
In human society today, computing machines have permeated our experience of life. The result of developing quantum computing devices gives us potentially enormous power to solve problems that are otherwise simply not solvable, either in principle or in practice.
And this isn't the kind of project that one organization could pull off by itself, because the team is developing a revolutionary approach to quantum computing. It had to build tools that didn't exist before in our labs to understand and test our ideas, such as the development of specialized devices for quantum computer chips.
We came together and said, okay, what would we need to do to seize this moment? We knew that we wanted to have a good memory technology that was really scalable. The second is we had to have a photonics technology that could scale along with that solid-state memory. And the best technology was actually at that time being developed at Sandia National Laboratory.
We essentially had the only platform that would really work for that purpose. And it was pretty evident to them and to me that we really could do something that we wanted to do to begin a long collaboration that gives us the freedom and the funding necessary to be able to really think through these problems and engineer them in a way that ultimately will allow them to be scalable and impact more than just the state of the art in science, but actually change the world.
The approach that we are pursuing in the quantum moonshot is based on utilizing the properties of light and properties of certain types of matter in a complementary way.
This idea of actually bringing the quantum resource state generators to make the photons themselves, the qubits, that's really the vision that, you know, Dirk and Jerry brought to the table.
So it's a lottery ticket to discover truly useful applications, but I think at the same time it's an admission ticket into a better understanding of the universe.
We literally build our photonic circuits in a volume CMOS foundry that also makes electronic integrated circuits. And it's what makes our version of the approach different. And ours is really the only one that can do this approach with Diamond that really has the scalability necessary to go all the way.
In this way, we have developed a scalable architecture that will enable us to achieve unprecedented control over the quantum mechanical states and enable scalable quantum computing to the level of millions of quantum bits that is required.
What's unique about the quantum moonshot, it's the mindset, it's the openness. It is that we try to put technology and scientific discovery first.
We have the people, we have the resources, we have the time, and we're able to publish our work and make sure that what we're doing is real and important and valued.
And so our work in quantum computing can help hopefully illuminate our understanding of the deepest mysteries of science, and all of the members of the Quantum Moonshot team are confident that we will achieve this goal.
Although no one can predict the future, we have a strong expectation that we will achieve the ultimate goal of a scalable, error-corrected, fault-tolerant quantum computer contained on a single chip. Thank you.
We'll be right back.